All right, welcome to weekly forecast on gold. This week, what am I expecting on gold? As of last week, you can see that the last candle that closed as a bearish RMI. But the first thing you need to consider whenever you are trading is the trend. The trend is your friend. You are always meant to follow the trend. So the trend is bullish, and we are meant to be looking for what? Bullish signals. Anything that is going to make us enter into a buy. That's what we are meant to be looking at. And now we are seeing a bearish RMI, which a bearish RMI is meant to pull the market down. Now, am I going to trade the sell biases? If I see the sell bias, I'm going to trade it. But then I'm more bullish than bearish. Despite seeing this, I'm more bullish than bearish because this could be a trap for sellers. But either ways, markets can either go either ways. So we are meant to prepare ourselves. But I will always advise my friends that whenever you are trading, the trend is your friend. If you are risking much, always risk much when you are trading the trend. But if you are counter trading, don't risk too much. So whenever you want to take a trade that is opposite the trend, risk very little. Very, very little. So now let's go to daily time frame, because you are meant to start from monthly or weekly time frame and whenever you want to start trading. Now go to daily time frame. Going to daily time frame, what can we see? We can see that when market came to this place, the next thing you are meant to do is to mark your support and resistance region. This is a support region because you can see that market came down to this place and rejected to where it was meant to take this all-time high. Market was meant to take this all-time high after rejecting from here, but you can see that market did not take the all-time high and started coming back down to where, to this same place where it's rejected. And you can see that there was a massive rejection of this zone. So two things can happen. This is also serving as a resistance zone right now. So two things can happen. Market can either break to the upside, let me just draw that. Market can either break to this upside, do this and up, or market will come down and do this, break this support and flush all this fair value gap down. Is it clear? So let me quickly delete that and proceed to the next thing. So this is daily time frame. This is what daily time frame is saying. So daily time frame is saying we are meant to wait. Probably on Monday, don't take any trade. Tuesday, watch the market and wait for any breakout before you take any trade. Then let's go to what Fowler is saying. What's Fowler saying? Before I go into what Fowler is saying, then you can also see that on daily time frame, the candles that we are seeing here, there are signs of indecision. You can see Doji is coming all the way from here. Doji, this one is also looking like a Doji and a Doji. They are giving us indecision. So we just need to listen to what the market is saying. And the market is telling us right now that it has not really made a decision to go up or down. So if you see anybody telling you to trade to the upside this week, be calm. Wait for a break of this place and follow the trade. And if you see anyone telling you to sell this week, wait for market to break this place and sell. I don't want this video to be a very long video, so I'll just quickly dive right in into 4 hours and see what 4 hours is projecting currently. Alright, so 4 hours is telling us that we are currently ranging and we need a break. We need a break. And as you can see, we are currently ranging. You can see this is one range, then market came down, came here, down, here, down. So on Monday, market can come here, and Monday or Tuesday, market can come here, then wait for a candlestick pattern formation. Wait for your candlestick pattern formation on 4 hours. If it gives you a candlestick pattern formation, it is going to come down. If it doesn't, it is going to break and continue to the upside. So if I was to trade, I'm not going to trade on Monday. I would love to wait for market to break, and I really want to trade to the upside because that's the trend. I really want to see a break of this place and then we'll go to the upside. So that will be my trade for this week. But if I see a trade for falling to the downside, what am I going to do? I might just risk a little, come here, and then follow them all the way to this place. And why am I following them all the way to this place? This is because that zone is also a resistance zone. You can see that market rejected from here, dropped down, came back here again, dropped down, came here, dropped, then broke. So market can come here and serve as support, and then we'll have our trade back to the upside because we are in a buy trend. So please don't get lost in the sell trade. In case you see a breakout of this place, don't get lost. You can patiently wait for markets to come to this place, give you a candlestick pattern formation, and then you trade it to the upside. Thank you.